If you've ever been flying your drone and you get distracted for just 1 minute,
ooh,
and then you look up and you're like,
where's my drone?
It happens to all of us. But don't you worry, in this video, I'm giving you the helpful tips to use maps to quickly and easily fly your drone back to you, coming up. Okay. And if you're new here, yo, I'm Christine Lozada, and this is Drone with CL. I love helping people to explore the world from the sky with their drones. Tons of tutorials here, so if you're into that, consider subscribing. I have tons of helpful tips for you, both on how to use maps, as well as how to fly it back to you. So let's dive straight in and send the drone. Let's start with the first tip, which is, where exactly is the map? So many people don't know it exists, and you can't use it if you don't know where it exists. So on the screen in the bottom left, you're gonna find that map. And sometimes it's fully down there, so pushing this bottom left button will kind of make it even smaller. But you can kind of also tap on it to make it a little bit larger. And then you can tap on it again to make it fill the whole screen. And you can see that your view has switched, right? What your camera sees is now small, and you can now see the map even larger. And so this is where the maps are located. Let's talk about how to read this map, because there's three things on the map that are really important. The first one is you. You are the blue circular dot. That's me sitting in my car talking to you right now, right there. H is your home point. And if you didn't watch my auto return to home video or return to home video, I talk about that more over there. But basically you can move the H around, move the home point around. But generally the home point, if you have not touched it, tends to be where you've launched your drone from, which is both you, your controller, and the drone are normally in the same spot. So that's H for home. And then the last important dot over there, or rather kind of arrowy thing, which is your drone. You can see the drone is facing away from me. And if I'm using the left stick to twirl it around, you can see that it twirls around so that it faces in different directions, right? That's what your left stick does, both up and down and twirling around. And so these are the three things to know on your map before we move on to the next part. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing, and come join us in the free drone Facebook group. There's a ton of amazing pilots over there. Tons of info on my full courses, one of which is free, in the description below. All right, let's jump into the next tip, which is a tip that's actually from my drone 101 course. So in my How to Fly a Drone Beginner course, I talk about the twirlie. And so in the twirlie, we are going to make sure we are ready to clear everything before we use the maps to fly back from us. So what I mean by that is, let's go ahead and bring back the view from our drone. Right now it's looking down, so I can't make sure I'm clearing everything if I were to start flying it back to me. I'm gonna bring the gimbal to zero. So I'm looking directly ahead. And you can see my current height right now is at 203 feet. And so I'm asking myself, at 203 feet, as I'm doing this twirlie, will I hit anything, right? So like here, maybe that guy, I might be 200. I'm using this center line to see if I'm gonna hit anything. Obviously I'm gonna clear like these buildings, I'm gonna clear all the trees, right? I'm putting it at zero, and I'm simply doing this twirlie to see if I'm gonna hit anything. But here's the next part, which is in using the map. When I'm using that map, I'm gonna go ahead and twirl the drone, leaving it in place, right? Not moving forward or back, just twirling in spot like a
beautiful ballerina.
And I'm gonna face it toward me, right? So my drone arrow is now facing toward me. And same thing with gimbal at zero, boom, I'm not gonna hit anything. So I know if I fly directly forward toward myself, I'm not gonna hit anything and I'm in the clear. And so I'm gonna do two things. I'm gonna simultaneously fly forward toward me while keeping an eye, tracing this red line back, directly back to me. So I'm still gonna look at both to make sure that even though I've done the twirly, I've done all the things, as I fly it back to me safely, I'm not gonna hit anything. So I'm gonna go ahead and start bringing the drone back toward me. And as I do so, you can see like my drone's actually not that far away from me right now. So I know that if I look, I can see my drone right now. Hello. And one of the things that I love to do is just bring it close enough to me see it, and then fly it in the rest of the way manually, not staring at the screens. But since we're here, let's show you one other trick. I love having the grid lines on. I talk about this in my drone advanced course because X marks the spot, and this is me hiding underneath the tree. So I'm gonna bring it down. X marks the spot. I know I'm gonna literally park my drone in the parking spot next to me. And so I'm gonna bring it down until I can see it, and then I'm gonna fly it over to me and hand catch it while sitting inside the car. Because why not? Let's bring it in front of the car so I'm not so strained. Hello, tight spaces. And this is another thing I teach in my advanced course, which is turn off obstacle avoidance. I'm gonna try to land this drone really tight inside this car, kinda, and I don't want it to hit anything, so I'm making sure obstacle avoidance is off. What's up, drone? And a little bit closer, just a little bit, and then let's catch it. Okay, got it. That's what you call a lazy person's way of catching a drone. All right, let's recap what we learned here today. We learned about how to use maps to fly your drone back to you. We learned about the location of where that's at on the bottom left of the screen. And we also learned about the three things that are on there, right? The home point, the dot that is you, i.e. the controller, and then there is the drone itself. And then we learned some tactics to be able to twirl and make sure we're not going to hit anything as we use the drone map to fly back close to us so we can see it again. And then we learned that it's important to use both the map and looking at the screen together to make sure you're, even though you cleared everything, you're still safe to come back. And then lastly, we learned to bring it near us and then finish that job yourself and finish out flying. Well, actually, maybe you want to send your drone back out again or bring it in, either way, but bringing it back close to you so that you know it's in range, so that you can see it again, and then do whatever it is you need to do next. If you got some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing, and don't forget to join us in the drone Facebook group. There's a ton of stuff like this in my course if that's what you're about, or subscribe to this channel. I got a lot more tutorials coming at you, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.